Welcome to video 3 in this 3-part series. In video 1, we went ahead and installed and set up the Capture app on your Android device. You can check out that video here in the corner. In video 2, I walked you through exactly how to properly scan your space using your Android phone. You can also find that video up here in the corner. And now in video 3, I want to take you through customizing and sharing your space. If you remember, the property that I scanned was a small pool house, basically a one-bedroom studio. I was able to scan the pool house with only 5 scans, so it didn't take me very long at all, and processing didn't take long at all either. So let's go ahead and check this out. I'm in my account at my.matterport.com, so I'll just open up my last model here. Now I'll just go ahead and hit the play button to see what this model looks like. And as I move around, you can see just how much stuff and clutter is in this room. This is really just being used more as a storage unit right now. And because of that, it's really hard to visualize how this space could potentially be used as a guest house. And that is exactly why I scanned it this way, to show you this new planning tool available in Matterport that allows you to see what size furniture you can put in this space without ever having to move anything around. And this is exactly the kind of thing that demonstrates the power of a Matterport digital twin with measurement accuracy versus just your traditional virtual tour that's really just a bunch of 360 images. So back to my model page, I just want to go into share and make sure that my model is shareable. This tool is only available if the model is shareable, so I'll close out of here and then go into details, scroll all the way down, go into visit labs, and this tool right here called Spatial Planner is what I want. I'll just click there. And now I just click on the room that I want to edit, and you can see immediately how the entire room has been cleared out of all that clutter and is now available for me to play around with. So just to take a quick step back, with 5 scans that took 5 minutes, I was able to capture a dimensionally accurate digital twin of my room without ever lifting a finger. And now I can go ahead and virtually plan how I want this space to look. All right, so let's add some furniture in here. I can just press the plus button here, add in a dresser. I can edit the size of this dresser. Maybe I saw one that I really like online. I can put in the size right here and then hit add. I can use these little corner bits here to rotate the dresser and move it into position. So I'm not looking for perfection here. I just want to know whether or not the furniture that I really like online, before I go ahead and buy that, will it actually fit in my space properly? I've already gone through this, so I'm just going to go ahead and load a previous layout. I'll load slot 1, and there's everything that I have for my new room. Because you have a dimensionally accurate digital twin, you can do this and know that it's actually going to fit in your space properly. And that's it, really quite simple. So now that the pool house project is all done, I want to take you through customizing your digital twin. And when I'm done customizing the space, I'll go ahead and grab the share link so I can use that everywhere the listing is being promoted. Go ahead and find the model in your account and just press edit in order to open it up in Workshop. Now you've got these tools over here on the right side. And the first thing we do is basically just go ahead and set a start position. So I'm gonna look around the room. This actually looks like a pretty decent view. So I'm gonna choose that, hit my start location right there, and just hit set. Now that my start location has been set, I can walk around and just check out the rest of this model. I can press the number 2, see the dollhouse. This is a super cute listing in Aptos, California. And so we're good there. If I wanted to hide any scans, I can do that in the 3D scans tool right here. There's really no need to have scan number 1 right here. That was more captured just to kind of fill in the 3D mesh. So I'll just press the little eyeball right over here on scan 1. And same thing over here, scan number 13, that kind of creeps a little bit into the bathroom. This too was captured really just to flesh out the complete 3D model. So I will hide scan number 13. And that's it, we should be set there. Okay. So with that done, I'll go on to the next one. I can grab photos. So I can not only grab photos of the dollhouse, I can go into the floor plan view and grab photos of the floor plan view. This also is helpful to include in my listing. People get a better sense of how the space is laid out. Of course, I can also go into the model itself and move around to grab photos this way and just press the little camera button down here to grab some photos. Now, this is pretty important. If there is anything in your scan that you really don't want to have included as part of the model, as part of the walkthrough experience, you know, right here is a picture of somebody that I don't want to have included, I can go ahead and use the blur tool. So this tool right here allows me to manually blur, and I can just press the plus sign. I don't need a brush that big, so I'll come down here, reduce the brush size a little bit. And the more I brush away at this, the blurrier it becomes. I can just press the check mark there. And remember, very important, you need to do this from all the different positions. So if I can see it from here as well, I'll press the plus symbol again. And again, just reduce the brush size a little bit more. There we go, press check. So now I've got those blurred out. Now I can add matter tags, and this is especially cool for listings. And there we go. So you can say, add another one down here. Done. So you can describe and have everything laid out with the matter tags so people know exactly where to go to find whatever they need. And last thing that I want to show you is the highlight reel. And this allows you to kind of create a highlight reel of different highlights, little photos, areas in the model that you want to highlight and point out to your visitors. So you can click there, and you don't need to use images, but you can just hit add view. It'll add this exact view right into the highlight reel itself. And I can move around then and go into the bedroom here and click a view of that. Of course, this particular space is very, very small, so I don't need the highlight reel per se here, but larger homes where you really want to have a guided tour, right, to kind of handhold the visitor through the space, showing them everything that they might need to see and become familiar with, this is a really, really good way to do that. Last thing, super important, of course, is to publish this. So before I leave the edit tool, what I want to do is press the publish button up here and hit yes, apply. The two blurs in this case are going to be applied. So in my case, I don't want to do that. I don't want to apply the blurs to this model. So I'll hit no. I can go back into my blur, and I'm just going to go ahead and delete these. And now I can go ahead and feel comfortable publishing without those blurs actually affecting the model. That's it. Once you have published all your changes, you're ready to copy your share link. You can do that right over here. Just exit and just press the share button right here. Go ahead and tap the copy link button here. And now that the link has been copied, I can go ahead and share this or paste it wherever with whomever I want. Now I want to show you something really cool from the visitor's perspective. So if I close out of here and I just open up a new tab and hit paste, I'll actually be able to visit the space that I had just customized. And what I can do if I'm a visitor coming to this space, I can come down here and press the little measure icon, press the plus, and I can go ahead and start measuring this room just to see if it suits my needs. So for example, I can go into the floor plan view and press the plus symbol here. I can tell that this is 4.59 meters. I can also come up here to settings and choose US Imperial. And very quickly and easily as a visitor, I can see the accurate dimensions of this room and really get a very complete understanding of this space. That's just one more example of how a digital twin with dimensional accuracy is very different from a virtual walkthrough. There are so many different ways you can use your digital twin. Homeowners can digitally document their property as well as everything in it for online appraisals, insurance purposes, or just to have that peace of mind. Builders are using digital twins to plan and manage construction projects online and collaborate inside the digital twin itself with designers, contractors, and clients. And of course, real estate agents are using their digital twins to create immersive walkthrough experiences where they too can navigate the virtual experience and meet up with clients inside the digital twin, as well as, of course, using that virtual experience across their own social network. So all that potential of having a digital twin can now be easily captured using your Android phone. I hope you found this information helpful.